Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Metro. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_030_DIAB_M. Click the File tab, hover the mouse cursor to save as, and select Project. Rename this file to 00_031_DIAB_M. Click the Save button. Double click the ground floor plan view to open the ground floor. Click into the drawing area and roll the mouse wheel forward to zoom in. Right click the reference plane and select grid similar. Go to draw panel and click the pick line command. Click the core face of this wall. Zoom into this area and click off this circle and extend this reference plane to the core face of this wall. Click the core face of this wall again. Click the circle and extend this reference plane to the left till it meets the core face of this wall. Click this wall. Click the modify button. Go to the measure panel and select the align dimension command. Select this reference plane and this reference plane. Move the mouse cursor to the right and click to place the dimension. Click the modify button. Right click the reference plane. Grid similar. Click the pick line command in the draw panel and enter a value, the value of this dimension 1350. Select the core face of this wall to offset this out. Click the modify button. Right click the reference plane, grid similar. Select the pick line command in the draw panel, change the distance to 3000 and offset this reference line down. Click the modify button. Select this reference plane, click on this bubble and move it, snap it to this other reference plane. Select this reference plane, click this circle and snap it to this reference plane. Click out to this selected reference plane. Right click the reference plane, grid similar. Draw another reference plane in between this reference plane and move up. Select the align dimension. Select this reference plane, this reference plane, this reference plane. Move down and click to place the dimension. Click the EQ button to equally constrain this reference plane. Click the modify button. Select the dimension and hit delete on your keyboard. Click on constrain. Zoom in into this area. Right click the reference plane. Grid similar. Set the offset distance to 300 mm. Click on the intersection of these two reference planes. And if the reference plane goes on the wrong direction, press the tab, the space bar to flip it over. And click here to complete the reference plane. Click the modify button. Now this reference plane is drawn 300 mm away from this. Now I click the reference plane, grid similar. Draw another reference plane from this point to this point. Select the align dimension command. Select this reference plane, and this reference plane. Move out to place the dimension and click the EQ button to equally constrain this reference plane. Click the modify button. Select the dimension and hit delete on your keyboard. Click OK. Select the dimension command. Click on this reference plane and this reference plane. Click to place outside. Click modify button. Select this reference plane and change this value to 2400. Press enter. Go to the architectural tab, circulation panel, and select the circle command. Click the modify button. Change the maximum riser height to 200 and the maximum tread depth to 300 and the maximum run width to 1250. Click OK. Make sure that automatic running is checked and center running location is selected. The base level must be ground floor plan, the top level must be first floor plan, and the base offset must be zero and the top floor offset must be zero. You see, Revit done the calculation in advance and indicate the number of stairs that we need. Click into this area and move the mouse cursor. Click. Zoom into this area and start from this point. Click. Now let's check the distance between these two. Now click the modify button. We need to edit these tiers. Select these tiers, hit delete. Select these tiers, click this arrow and move it down. Select grid similar and start the tier here to continue and finish the tiers. Now let's measure the distance between the two places. All right, this distance is okay, 1500 millimeters. Click the green check mark. The tier is complete. Now go to the default 3D view to see the results, but you cannot see the results in this view. I'm going to show you another command which we're going to use to see everything that you want to see inside your project. Let's go and rename this 3D view. Click the plus sign, the 3D in curly brackets, and click rename. Rename this to 3D view ground floor and click OK. Right click the view cube, select orient to view floor plan and select the ground floor plan. Now hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. You see the result of the staircase that you just drew. But you cannot see the full staircase because the rivet cropped the stairs at the top. Select the section box and click on this arrow and move it up. Remove too much. Click on one of the view cube face. Zoom closer. Click to move it down like this. Orbit to see the result. This is our staircase. We need to delete the railing on this part. Go to the ground floor plan. Select the railing. Click edit part. Select this and hit delete. Select this railing and hit delete. Click the green check mark. Go to the default 3D view. Oh, as you can see, the default 3D view have changed. We need to do some setting because the one that we were using previously, we have renamed it to another view. So to handle this, click on the view detail and change it to fine, and click on the visual style display and change it to see. Now go to the project browser and double click the 3D view ground floor to see the results. Go to the ground floor plan, go to the modify tab and select the trim extend multiple element. Select the core face of this wall and click these two walls to extend them to this wall. Click the modify button, right click this wall, grid similar. Draw a wall from this point to this point. Click the modify button. Select the align command. Click on the edge of the staircase and click the core face of this wall. Click the modify button. Now select the dimension command. Click the face of this wall to see the results. Click the modify button. Now go to the modify panel and select the split element command. Make sure that the delete inner segment is checked. Click on this wall and this wall. Click on this wall and this wall. Click the modify button. Select this door and use the up arrow key to notch this door up. Select this door and notch this door down. Go to the 3D view ground floor to see the results. You need to control this wall. Select this wall. Click edit profile. Click close. Select the pick line command in the draw panel and click to the edge of this landing. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this sketch line and this sketch line. Click the modify button. Select this sketch line and hit delete on your keyboard. Click the green check mark to end the command. Click on join. Now go to the ground floor plan. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the section command. View from this point to this point. Click this arrow to flip the section over. We want to see this area. Right click the section and go to view. Select this wall. Click edit profile. Click close. Select pick line command. Pick the edge of this slab and this slab. Select the trim extend to corner. Trim from this corner to this corner. This to this. Click the modify button. Select the sketch line and hit delete on your keyboard. Click the green check mark, click on join. Go to the project browser and open the 3D view ground floor to see the result. Click the modify button to deselect. Now we're going to create a general toilet in this area for the visitor. Go to the ground floor plan, right click this door, create similar and place a door here. Click modify button, select the door, go to edit type and click duplicate. Change the width to 600 millimeter Okay, 600 millimeters already exists. So click close and click the down arrow. Select the 600 by 2100 millimeter. Click OK. The door adjusted immediately. Now double click the section view to open it view. Go to the ground floor plan. Now we need to reduce the height of this door. But before we do, let's measure the door. The distance from the ground floor to the stringer. Select the align dimension command, click on the ground floor and click the edge of the stringer. The edge of the stringer is 1850. Now click the modify button, select this door, edit type and select duplicate. You name this door to 600 by 1800 millimeter, click OK. Change the height to 1800 millimeter, click OK. We still need to adjust this door. Select the door, go to modify, edit, click edit type and select rename. Change the distance to 1750 millimeter. Change the height to 1750 millimeter. Click OK. Click the X button to close the figure. Go to the project browser 3D view and double click the 3D ground floor. Orbit around, select the sphere and click the edit sphere. Select the stringer, hold down the control key and click on this stringer along the wall. This stringer, hit delete, delete the dimension. Select this stringer and hit delete. Select this stringer and hit delete. Click the green check mark. Now we need to update this wall to meet the stairs. Select this wall, click edit profile. Go to the ground floor plan and open this section view. Zoom in into this area. Select the align command. Click the edge of this stair landing and align the sketch line to that landing. Select the pick line command in the draw panel. Zoom in into this area and pick the underside of the stairs. This stairs and the edge of this stairs. Select the trim extend to corner, select this sketch line, click the modify button, select this and hit delete on your keyboard. Click the green check mark. Go to the project browser and double click the 3D view ground floor to see the result. Select this, go to the ground floor plan, select this section view and drag it down. Click the flip arrow, right click, go to view. Now select this wall, click edit profile, select the align command and click the edge of the landing and align this object to that edge. Go to draw panel and click the pick line command. Click the underside of the stairs and the edge. Select this trim extend to corner, select this object and this object, click the modify button, select the sketch line and hit delete on the keyboard. Click the green check mark. Go to the project browser and upgrade 3D view ground floor to see the results. Go to the ground floor plan, select the stairs, click edit stair, select these stairs and click to move it out to align it to the wall. Click this to move it out and align it to the wall. Click the green check mark. Go to the 3D view ground floor to see the results. Go to the default 3D view. If you leave it, ask you to save your project, write and save your project. Click the view cube between, click this vertex and click the zoom extent command. Click the save button. Alright, we created the main stairs of the project. In the next tutorial, we'll create a stair from the garage to the first floor. If you like this tutorial, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.